Blackstone Publishing presents Burn Our Bodies Down by Rory Power. This book is read by Lauren Ezzo. I was so proud not to feel my heart. Waking means being angry. Eliza Griswold, Ruins. 1. Flick and catch of the lighter. Fire blooming between my fingers. It's too hot for this. Late June, sun close and watchful. Here I am anyway, flame guttering in and out, in and out. The candle I lit this morning is on the coffee table. Scented cloves and pine. Mom stole it from work last year, and we've been putting off using it, burning every other thing we can find. A bowl of tea lights, clean and bright, or a prayer candle she took from church. But we're running low, and this Christmas shit was the only one left in the box Mom keeps under her bed. Too sweet, too strong. But the rules are more important. They're always more important. Keep a fire burning. A fire is what saves you. The first. The last. The heart of them all. She taught me that as soon as I was old enough to hold a lighter in my palm. Whispered it to me in the dark. Pressed it against my forehead in place of a kiss. And I used to ask why, because it makes less than any sense at all. But you learn quick when you're Joe Nielsen's daughter. It's answers or her. And you'll only ever get one of them, so you'd better be careful deciding which it is. I picked her. And even so, I don't get much of her most days. With one hand, I test the breeze coming through the window I'm sitting at. It's barely anything, but I want to be sure it won't put the candle flame out. She pretends not to care about that anymore, says the lighting is the important thing. And it is. It is. She watches me do it every morning with this look on her face I'll never understand. But still, I remember the fight we had the first time she came home to a blackened, bare wick. I won't let that happen again if I can help it. Especially not these days, with Mom always in a mood, holding herself open like a trap. I get up from the windowsill and slide to the floor, tilt my head into the shade, floorboards sticking to my thighs, salt on my tongue every second. Above me I can see the smoke gathering, blue against the crackling ceiling. Nothing to worry about. Detectors disabled ages back. Mom ripped them down herself, paid the fire department to stop coming around. They turned off the electricity that month, but it was worth it. To her, anyway. And me? I went to school, and I came home, and I did my homework with a flashlight between my teeth. Made a life for myself inside the mess of my mother's head, just like always. I think I'd give anything to know what happened to leave her like this. As long as it's not waiting to happen to me. The sun's dropped and left the room dim by the time I hear the station wagon rattle up outside. Mom, back from her shift at the funeral home. She works at the front desk and takes all the calls, tells people if the coffin they picked is too short, helps them order enough whiskey for the wakes. Footsteps on the stairs, but I don't stand up. My whole body languid and heavy, the humid air pinning me down. Mom can carry the groceries by herself. She's a mess when she gets inside. Hair loose, sticking to her mouth, and a coffee stain on the lapel of her shirt. We look so alike that people are always calling us sisters, and not in a way that's flattery. The same somber mouth. The same streaks of gray at our temples. Mine came early.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.